Hello, good afternoon everyone. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to show you how to configure routing protocol using OSPF in GNS3. In this example, I will use AS number 100.0.0 as example for all routers. I have 6 routers here. So all the 6 routers will be used AS number 100.0.0 so that all will be routing together. Okay. In this diagram, I have 4 different networks that I want to link to each other. What are these networks? 1. PC1 having 192.168.1.0/24 networks, which is connected to router 1. Another one is PC2 192.168.2.2/2.0 network/24 connecting to router 1. And one more network is 192.168.3.0/24 is PC3 connecting to router 5. And the last one is 192.168.4.0/24 connecting to router 5. My purpose in this lab, I will configure a OSPF routing protocol. It is in dynamic routing protocol to be able for 4 PCs, PC1, PC2, PC3, and PC4 can connect to each other. Unless we need to configure the routing protocol, if we without routing protocol, these 4 PCs cannot link to each other. Okay, let's start all devices. Okay, while we are starting the routers, I want to show some IP address and ID planning. For each router, I need router ID for OSPF protocol. So I assign router 1 as an ID 1.1.1.1 and router 2 2.2.2.2 and so on. Why I need this? Because routing protocol OSPF, they need AS number and router ID to broadcast or advertise to each other. And connection between routers, router 1 to router 2, I'm using IP address /30, which is 11.11.11.0 and so on. Okay, for each connection from router to router, I have its own address. Okay, only two IP addresses. Okay, that's it. We can start configuration now. First, we can configure IP address on PC. Okay. Right click on PC1 console. Let me make the font bigger. Yes. To assign IP address on GNS3 PC, we type IP space then the address 192.168.1.2/24 gateway 192.168.1.1. Okay. PC2 IP 192.168.2.2/24 Gateway 192.168.2.1 PC3 IP, sorry, make it bigger. /24 192.168.3.1 is a gateway. To make it this configuration of the IP address in PC stay all the time when you close your GNS3 software, you need to type another command to save the IP address configuration. When you type it save, it means that this IP address configuration will stay in the virtual PC. When you save and then you close this program and then you start again, you open this file again, PC will have IP address. You no need to configure again. So I go back to PC1. I forgot to save PC2. Also, I forgot to save. Then PC4. I'm sorry. PC4. Let me stop and start. Because I confused to paste the PC3 IP address. Right click. When you right click on the black background, it means you are pasting text into the command. So go to settings, change font size 14. Okay, IP 192.168.4.2/24 Gateway 192.168.4.1 Save. Okay, we have done configuration for all four PCs. Now let's go to router 1. Okay, right click console, make it bigger. Okay, for before the configure IP address and the routing protocol, I want to show you this command. This command is for security reason, because we want to protect our routers. Okay, this command is for setting up telnet password, enable password. Without this command, you cannot telnet to this router. So this command is for enable telnet with the password Cisco. This command will be the password for console. And this is the enable password and encryption password. Okay, these two commands, we need to hide the alerting when you turn on ports or shut down ports or turn on VLAN and so on. It will be announced that your interface came to up, your interface chain to down, something like this, and you don't want to see these messages, and then you want to turn it off. If you want to turn it off, you need to type these two commands. Okay, so to save the time for all six routers, I just copy and paste to all routers. Okay, so router one, I right click on this area, any area in this background. Okay, just right click, it will be assign the telnet password, console password, and enable password. Okay, so now we start configure our router. Let's close this one. Router one, I have three interfaces. 2/0 connecting to PC two. Okay. 1/0 connecting to PC one. 0/0 connecting to another router. Okay. IP address is this one. Let's go to interface G0/0. Is the interface connecting to another router. We assign IP address 11.11.11.1, okay, /30, 255.255.255.252, no shut. Do not forget to type no shut. No shut or no shutdown is mean you are enabling enabling port to use. If you don't use no shut or no shutdown, the port will be stay shut down or disabled. Then we go to another port, G1/0, IP address 192.168.1.2/24. No, we cannot say slash here. We can say slash for IPv6 only. For IPv4, we cannot say slash here like in PC. In virtual PC, we can write in slash. Okay, 255.255.255.0. No shut. Okay, INT G2/0, IP address 192.168.2.1. I'm sorry, because I have made a mistake of this. This IP should be belong to PC, not belong to router. I will make a change. 2.1, 255.255.255.0. No shut. I go back to G1/0. Then I type no IP. Okay, I remove this IP address. Okay, then I add a new IP address 1.1. Okay, it's a gateway of PC1, gateway of PC2. Now we have done configuration of the IP address. We have assigned IP address to these three interfaces already. So now let's do it routing protocol. OSPF, we have AS number 100 and area 0. How to do that? We need to exit from the interface mode to the config mode. In the config mode, you type router space, and then you type OSPF space, and then the AS number. Okay. You change 100 to another number, which is your own AS number. Okay. So my in my case, I have AS number 100. Okay. Press enter. Next, I need to assign router ID. Router ID 1.1.1.1. And then I advertise my own network to other routers. Okay, network that I need to advertise, I have three networks, one network, two network, and this also network, which is connected to my router. So 192.168.1.0 subnet mask. We need to do subnet mask, but this subnet mask is not like this. It's not like this. We cannot type like this. We need to type wildcard subnet mask. What is a wildcard subnet mask? Wildcard subnet mask, if you don't know how to calculate wildcard subnet mask, please watch my another video on my channel talking about wildcard subnet mask. Okay, wildcard subnet mask offer /24 is 0.0.0.255. Okay, this is the wildcard subnet mask for /24. Space area 0. Okay, I have three networks, 2.0, and one more is 11.11.11.0. But this one is /30, it's not /24. /30 is 0.0.0.3. Okay, how to calculate that? Please watch my another video of how to calculate wildcard subnet mask. Enter. Done. Okay, we have done configuration router 1. Exit. And then you do not forget to write the command. Write all configuration. Okay, do not forget it. When you type WO, it means you are writing all your configuration into RAM. Okay, into RAM. Now let's configure router 2. Go to console, make it bigger. Okay, the same thing. I need to paste all this security here to save the time. You can write it down and then you can type it. Okay, router 2, we have how many connection? 2 connection. One is connecting to router 1, one is connecting to router 3. Okay, router 2, we go to interface G0/0, IP address 11.11.11.2, because .1 we already used in router 1. Okay, so it's /30 255.252. No shut. Okay, and then we go to INT G2/0, IP address 222.22.22.2/30/252. No shut. Okay, then we configure OSPF. Let me show this router here. Okay, you will see something loading here after I configure OSPF in this router 2. Okay, now let's go to router OSPF AS number 100. Okay, and then router ID 222 and network that I advertise is 11.11.11.0.0.0.0.3 area 0. Okay, one more. 22.22.220. Okay, /30 area 0. I think because I have disabled the announcement, so no problem. We will show later, okay? We will show later. Now we have done configuration of router 2. That's it. We go to router 3. No, I forgot to save it. Okay. Right. Okay. Router 2. Done. Yes. Okay. Done. Router 3. We go to router 3. Make it bigger. Okay. In router 3 we have three interfaces which is linked to all three routers. Yeah, another three routers. Okay, let me put it here. Okay, let me copy it again and paste it here. Okay. And then I go to interface G2/0, which is connecting to router 2, IP address 22.22.1. Okay, because we have used the 2 already. /30.252. No. Shut. Okay, INT G0/0 link to router 4, IP address 33.33.33.1/30. Okay, 255.252. No shut. INT G1/0 IP 66.66.66.1.255.255.255.252. It's it from the interface, and we configure routing protocol router OSPF 100 router ID 3.3.3.3. Okay. Network 22.22.22.0. Wildcard subnet mask 0.0.0.3. Area 0. Okay, and we have 66.66.66.66, and we also have 3.3.33.33. Yeah, done. Then we save the command, save all configuration of router 3. Router 4, router 5, and router 6 are configuration the same. Okay, let's go to router 4. Let's go to router 4. Paste all here and go to. I make it bigger first. Yeah, go to interface G0/0 INT. This will be 33. Okay, IP 33.33.33.2. Okay, we have used one there already. 255.255.255.252. Okay. No shut. INT G1/0 for router 4 here. G1 slash 0, IP will be 44, okay? IP 44.44.44.2.255.255.255.252. No, sorry. I forgot address. No, shut. Because I want to use .2 and .2 the same. This one .2, all are .2. If this one .1, all are .1. Okay. This is my planning. We have done configuration IP address, so we go to routing protocol. Router OSPF AS number 100. Router ID. This is router 4, will be 4.4.4.4. Network 44.44.44.0. Wildcard subnet mask 3. Area 0. One more is 33, right? Then we go to write all configuration. Okay, write all configuration. It's taking some time to write. Leave it, let it writing. We go to router 5. We go to router 5. Router 5, we have 4 interfaces. Okay. Now we go to interface G1/0, which is connecting to router 4. So IP address will be this one. I have used .2 there already, so I use .1 here. IP address 44.44.44.24/30. No shut. INT G0/0. Okay. Connecting to router six. Okay. IP address 55.55.55.1.255.255.255.252. Okay. What is missing? Sorry, my typing problem. No shut. And then go to G2/0. INT G2/0. IP address 192.168.3.1. Okay, here this is the address. /24.0. No shut. Then go to G3/0. IP address 192.168.4.1/24. No shut. Okay, we have done configuration assigning IP address to each interfaces. Okay, so exit from interface mode. Here in this config mode, we go to router OSPF AS number 100, router ID, router 5, network 192.168.3.0, wildcard subnet mask. / Ja, wir 0 and 4 and 5. Okay. 5 5 5 5 5 0. It's not slash 24, it's slash 30. Okay. And one more is 44 network. 44 44 44. Done configuration router 5. Right configuration. Then we go to router 6. Let me check router 3, because this router 3 we have assigned 33.1, I think. 33.1. And router 5 also .1. So this will be .2, okay? 55.2 router 4, router 6. Router 6. INT G0/0 G0/0 IP 55 55 55 dot 2. I think this one, because of this one we have used one already. Please confirm router 5. This interface is 55 55 dot 1. Okay. Because if you assign the same address, will be conflict. So this are .1. So router 6 will be .2, okay? Because it's only two IP addresses. 4/30. No shut. Then we go to interface G1/0. INT. G1/0. Make sure router 3 IP address G1/0. You have configured G1/0 is .1, so here is not .1, is .2. Okay, 6666.2, because .1 is already used in router 3. Okay, be careful with this. Okay, be careful with this. So go back to router 6, IP address 66666.2, 255.255.255.252. Let me confirm it again. This is .1 already, so this will be .2. Okay, remember that. Enter. No shut. Okay, we have done configuration on router 6 assigning IP address. So now let's go configure routing protocol. Is it from interface mode? We are in config mode. We go to router OSPF 100. And then router ID 6666. Advertise network, we have only two networks to advertise. 55 55 55 dot 0 0 dot 0 dot 0 dot 3, area 0 and 66 66 66. That's it. Write the comment. Let me show you the result. Okay, why I have these four routers connected to each other as a circle? Okay. Whenever you have lost this connection, the traffic will be coming through this one. If you lost this connection, the traffic will go this way. That's why we say dynamic routing protocol, because it will find a way to reach the destination. And the same thing on router 5 connection, If this connection has lost, it will be coming to this way. If this connection is lost, will be coming through this way. Okay, for router 2, there is only one connection. There's no backup link. Okay, let me try to show you routing table for each router. Okay, let's show router 1. To see routing table in global mode or in enable mode, you need to type show run. Sorry, show run is showing all configuration. I need to show run first that I configured correctly or not. You need to confirm. Okay, yeah, I have configured correctly. Let's show routing table. Show IP route. Okay, now you have learned IP address from all routers. Router 1, you have network 192.168.1 and .2 only. But in your routing table, you also have 0.20, which is you have learned from router 5. Okay, you have learned from router 5 from which link, you know, through this link 11.11.11 here, network here. What is O mean? O is mean OSPF. So it means you have configured ROC correctly. Okay, because in your routing table, you have not only in your local address, but also from other address, from other router. Let's check router 2. Router 2, let me drop it here. Router 2 show IP route. This command show IP route is the command to show routing table. Okay. Space bar for more. Yeah. Now you have everything. On router 2, there are no 192, but on router 2, you have also all 192, all four networks. Okay, all four networks. You have learned from 2.2 and 1.1. Okay. What about router 3? What about router 3? We go to router 3. Show IP route. Okay, let's make it bigger. It's more easy to look. Okay, show IP route. Space for more. Okay, let's take a look here. You have learned router 3. In router 3, you have learned IP address 192.168.3.0 and 4.0 through this IP address. Why not 6? Why not 66? Why 33? It means that this router 5 advertised to router 3 through this link. Why not this link? Because sometimes they think that this link will be slower, so it going here. Later I will disconnect this link and then you will see this IP address is coming from 66 address. Okay, now let's go to router 6 routing table. Show IP route. Okay, you have this 55, all 55 here from this network. Why all from 55? As I told you just now, it will think that this link will be faster. So now select go to router 5 and show IP route. Okay, everything working fine. Okay, everything working fine. Now let's test ping from PC to PC. Now let's go to PC 1. I want to ping to PC 4. Okay, PC 4 is here. 192.168.4.2. Yes, I got a reply from PC 4. Let's ping to PC 3. I also got a reply from PC 3. Let's go to PC 3. Then I ping back to PC 1 and PC 2. I got a reply from PC 1. And I ping to PC 2. I also got a reply from PC 2. Okay, I think that's it for our lab. We have successful configuration for OSPF with AS number 100 area 0. Okay, any questions, please ask. Oh, one more thing. Let me show you how to, let's say, if this connection has lost, let's say, if this connection has lost, I go to router 4 and disable, I shut down this interface, G0/0, router 4, where's router 4 here? I will shut down interface G0/0, see what happened. Config terminal. INT G0/0, then I shut down. I shut down this interface. So now this interface has shut down. So let me go to router 3. Just now, router 3. You have learned from 33. IP address, which is from router 4. You have learned this address 192.168.3.0 through router 4. But now router 4 has lost link from router 4 to router 3 already. Has lost the connection already. So what happened next? Let's show routing table again on router 3. See what is different. So IP route. Has not yet learned from this address. Okay? Has not yet learned from this address. We'll wait for some time. Let's show router 6. We need to wait for some time. Why it's still not coming? Let me see. What happened? Router 3. I'm going to see router 3. So run. This is troubleshooting. I need to see router 3 configuration. Why it's not coming? Yes, because router 3 we has not yet give the command no shut. So we go to router 3. Interface 1/0 here, 1/0, router 3, okay, config t, int g1/0, no shut, Because we forgot to give command no shutdown. Okay, let's check it again on router 3. Show IP route 3. Show IP route. Wait for some time. Yes. Now you have seen this. Just now, these two network is coming from 33 network, but now it's coming from 66 network, which is this network, because we have shut it down this address already. Okay. So this is my lab that I show you how to configure routing protocol OSPF on GNS3. I think that's all for today. Yes, any question, please ask me. Thank you for watching.